joy, rapture, glory, hallelujah. Let the angels sing. It was November 11th, 19 blah blah. Milwaukee, Wisconsin, one of the coldest day on record, and a ray of sunshine was born. Ta-da. It was me. Now, at least that's what they say. I really don't remember. But they tell me I was there. I'll have to believe them. So much of my early life, there is no memory. Those moments in time, I have no recollection of. I am told that it was mainly eat, sleep, repeat. Eat, sleep, repeat. As I thought about this speech, and I was thinking about all this collection of moments in time that comprise of my memory, what is it I want to share with my fellow Toastmasters of who I am? And that is really difficult to do, because I all of a sudden realized that even though they say no man is an island, we kind of are. Because unless we share a moment in time, there is no frame of reference. I see colors different than you. I might taste things differently than you. I have different likes and dislikes than you. And unless there's a common ground for us to share, how do we relate? I could give you all these great accomplishments that I did, though it's really not that many. Or I could give you this whole cornucopia of all my escapades and not so great things. But let's stick with some of the facts. I am a product of my environment. I was born and raised in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And Milwaukee is known for
beer.
I happen to enjoy a good stout. Porter. Blonde. Ale. Lager. IPA. I became a connoisseur of beer. I love beer. Actually, I don't drink as much as I used to, but I still enjoy a good beer. It doesn't matter what kind it is, because I love to enjoy for the nuances it is. And I have to believe that's part of a product of my environment. Every day going to school, we drove by the Budweiser Brewery, and the Swiss Brewery, and the Pabst Brewery, and the Blatz Brewery. Wisconsin is also known for
cheese.
No, cow patties and beer parts. Cheese is secondary. Yes, I am a cheesehead. I love a good cheddar. And Colby. And Brie. And Stilton. And Monterey Jack. And mozzarella. I love cheese. The average American eats 34 pounds of cheese a year. Amateurs! I would do that every other month. I was buying it by the 5 and 10 pound blocks. I would buy whole wheels. I don't do that so much anymore, because I learned that that's really not that healthy for you. But I still love cheese. I have to believe that also was a product of my environment. Another place we drove by on the way to school was the Harley Davidson factory. Guess what I'd ride? A Harley Davidson. I love riding a Heritage Softail, a Deluxe, a Lowboy, a Street Glide, a Limited. If it says Harley on it, I love it. I am a product of my environment. But these are all just moments in time that I remember growing up, and it has extended into my adulthood. There are many things in my life, important events, like getting married. It was like a baseball game. You make first base, second base, third base, and you're at the home run, and you want to have a successful marriage. I'm up there, and I swing, and the marriage didn't last. Strike one. That's okay. I'm at bat again, and I make first base, second base, third base, home run, and does the marriage last? And I swing, and strike two. Comes again, first base, second base, third base, home run, love that home run, I'm getting ready to swing, and guess what?
Home run.
Home run! It's not three strikes you're out, it's three times the charm. I don't know how to share all the moments of my life with you. Many of them are very special. And as I was trying to think of this, especially after going to Jeremy's father-in-law's funeral, I had to think about the ending of life. And from time to time, I like to write a little poetry. And I have a poem for the ending. What will my future be? Through the mist of time, I cannot see. Maybe a clue from the past could impart. Maybe it will end as it began at the start. Eat, sleep, repeat. Eat, sleep, repeat. And when my final trip around the sun is made, how long before the memories of me will fade? And when my eyes smiles no longer see, my ears no longer voices hear, what will be written on my stone? The truth is, I will no longer care.